Hi guys, this is Kalura Hudson of While They Play Designs, and in this video I'm going to show you guys how to create an elastic bind off. If you take a look at this shawl, you can see I have a lace edging at the end and I've got a very stretchy elastic bind off that just allows all of those lace stitches to kind of let the bind off follow that lace edging. So it's just a nice flexible elastic bind off, and I'll show you how to create that. So I have a piece of work here that I've worked up just as a swatch, and you can see I've already started that lace edging here, and I'm just going to go ahead and show you that elastic bind off. And what you'll want to do is go with a needle size to do your bind off that's about three sizes larger than the needles you used for your project. So I knitted this piece in size US 4. So I'm just gonna bind off with a size 7 needle. And of course, if you're binding off a project with lots of stitches and you're using circulars, you can just simply take your needle that's three sizes larger and then put that onto your interchangeable needle, or you can grab another set of needles in the larger size. So for this video, I'm just going to use an interchangeable needle, just all on its own. So what we're gonna do, get that needle out of the way so it's not flopping around. We're going to do this bind off basically knit-wise. So we're gonna start by knitting two stitches, the beginning of our row. And then we're going to place those two stitches back onto our left-hand needle purlwise. And we're going to leave that right needle in our work. And we're simply going to knit those two stitches together through the back loop. And then we can remove that. And then we'll start the same process. We'll knit one stitch so that we have two on our right-hand needle. Slide those back onto the left-hand needle purlwise and leave your working needle in the back. And then knit those two stitches together through the back loop and pull them off. So again, you're knitting one stitch, pulling it off, slipping those two stitches back onto the left-hand needle, and knitting them together through the back loop and removing it. So I'm going to speed that up a little here. Knit together through the back loop, remove, knit one stitch. I think I'm getting out of the frame here. Slide back to the left-hand needle, knit them together through the back loop. Knit one, pull it off, slide those back onto the left-hand needle, knit them together through the back loop. And I'm just gonna stop here and show you guys my work. You can see we've kind of replicated just a standard knitted bind off, but we have nice elongated bind off loops there. And that's what creates that stretchy or elastic bind off. So I'm gonna continue working here. Knit one, remove that from the left-hand needle, place them back on the left-hand needle and knit them together through the back loop and remove. Knit one, pull off, slide those two back on, knit two together through the back loop and then pull off. And you'll just continue that all the way across your piece of work. So I'm gonna do that all the way to the end and I'll show you how that looks. Okay, so I've almost reached the end. Okay, I've got one stitch left. So knit that. Now I just have those two stitches, so I'll slide those back onto the left-hand needle and knit them together. Okay, and then I'll stop and show you guys how this looks. So as you can see, well, get it where you can see it. You can see that's a nice elastic bind off so that when you are ready to soak and block your piece of work, you'll be able to pull out the points of your shawl to show off any lace work that you've done, just like so. So that is how you work the elastic bind off. So I hope this technique and video helps you guys out. Thanks so much for watching.